has a good beat. Uncle Ben. She reached up in the cabin, found some string, man, put a foot in it.
He like a king.
And then I gotta finish the story, because then someone who was at the church that people used to say would talk about us showed up and gave my sons, they wanted gold chain for Christmas. That's all they wanted. And we couldn't afford it. Listen to me.
Come on.
And she showed up with two gold chains.
That's right.
Don't tell me what God won't do. Don't tell me what God won't do. Don't you tell me what God won't do.
All right.
And so, shortly after that, she wrote the song. And every now and then, I just have to hear it.
Yes, sir.
Because God has blessed us with that. Mm-hmm. I hope it ministers to you as you're riding in the car or sitting at home or playing on your job. And just remember what God has done for you.
That's right.
Because I have no doubt in my mind, to spend these last few hours with you all, that God has truly blessed you. Am I right about it, brother?
Yes, you are.
He's done better than you than you've ever thought about doing.
Yes,
sir.
Yes, sir.
And when you couldn't see your way, when you couldn't make a way out of the way, God was the way.
Yes,
how do you know? Because he said in his word, I am.
Yes, sir.
The way. And every now and then in church, you need to get in the way. I'm done with that. I'm getting started. I want to get back to where we were and let y'all go get a good night's sleep and just enjoy Jesus. I went to the room, my wife and I found a Walmart. We went over to Walmart for a few moments. Walmart is Walmart.
Amen.
It's something about Walmart, man. You know, okay, where you go? Walmart and Walmart. And I guess that's where God was messing with me, because I went to the room and took a nap. Till somebody knocked on the door with some soup. That's all. It was good soup. She nodded, so I tasted it. But the Lord woke me up and he showed me how uniformed Walmart is. Watch this. God make a sermon out of anything.
Yes, he can.
And he showed me how everywhere you go, anybody ain't go to Walmart anymore? Rudy said.
She got stock in
the building. She got stock in it. I get that, because her Bella's sister got stock in Kmart.
Oh, does she?
If you ever see Kmart change the name to Bryn Mawr, her sister named Bryn. And so you go to Walmart I'm like, God, you really got a sense of humor, because he showed me the uniformity of Walmart. And how wherever you go, Walmart, they're gonna be Walmart, and they got their sections don't change.
That's right.
And in most cases, the stores are the same.
Yeah, that's true.
You walk in the store, and you can just about know, you go left, right, forward, back, and the stores are generally the same. But what about Christians? What about us?
All right, Bridget.
If we all say we're Christians,
Why
are we so different?
Yes.
I don't serve different Jesuses.
He the same.
The word of the Bible said.
Yeah.
He the same.
Yesterday.
Today.
But I look at us. And I heard now and then, I wonder what I'm about to get. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
And so I'm going to preach about Walmart. No.
Amen.
What I do want to follow up this morning, and God really changed it, because I had something else I wanted to do. Kind of gave Brother Pastor a heads up, but he said, no, I want you to follow up and talk about the cost of following Jesus. And if the same Jesus we get is the same Jesus yesterday, today, and forevermore, and we're going to follow him, then when folks see us follow him, they ought to see us the same.
Yes, sir.
Am I right about it?
Yeah.
Do y'all know wishy-washy people?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. You said that's right. Yeah, well, don't y'all know some wishy-washy people?
No.
How many of y'all really like being around wishy-washy people?
No.
You really gotta do everything you can to get away from. Oh, here they come, oh boy. I don't know what I'm about to get. Chameleon Christians.
Mm.
And just in case you didn't know that, there's one in every church.
Yep. I know that.
We was talking over there, and then I heard them talking about that, about the ones that got to go to the bathroom every 5 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
Then we got them.
Oh, yes.
They've been doing my church for 3 years, and I don't care. As soon they go, when they come in, they sit and get up. Bathroom.
Uh-huh.
Offering, they get up and go to the bathroom. Pastor get up and preach, they go to the bathroom. I'm like, hey, man. And I I'm trying to be nice. See, earlier I said I'm going home to Youngstown, but now I know I'm coming back, so I want to be nice. Let's talk about the cost of following Jesus. Can we do that?
Yes, sir.
I want to remind you that, you know, we've had a great time in these last few hours. I hope you enjoyed what God is doing.
Amen.
And I appreciate what, you know, he brought us here for. And he asked us specifically, why are we here?
Mm-hmm.
And notice I said, why are we here?
Yes.
Because I remind you very clearly that this is not just for you. There's no question in my mind that God brought us here for him to work on us.
Amen.
To remind me, he does not even want me to be a chameleon Christian.
Come on, man.
And everybody that sees me and Pastor Bird, because we wear the title after him, they don't. You don't need to wonder, well, if I go to Pastor today, what are you going to be like? Did y'all know that pastors like that?
Come on, man.
Matter of fact, we had a conversation about one at lunch. Hello? Good point. Huh? There are chameleon pastors too, just
yeah,
in case
right.
You don't know it. And God's trying to get us on one accord.
Yes, sir.
And in one place.
Mm-hmm.
Headed to one direction. And until we can understand who Jesus is and actually follow him, not just, we already went through the cost. I'm not going to focus on the cost tonight. We talked about four people, and God showed us through those four people that we have no earthly security. We got to understand and remind. I'm going to remind you that no matter what you're doing, if you're going to follow Jesus, you don't have no earthly security. If you're going to follow Jesus, the followers of Jesus have no earthly ties. Let them go. They don't want to follow you. Let them go. Now, Jesus has not made one of y'all go to church.
That's right.
If you decide on Sunday morning you don't want to get up and go. Now, let me fix that, because I know some of us got folk in the house, and you're going to say, me and my house, we're going to serve the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
I got a grandson who's 14. You in my house, you going to church.
All right.
I got a son that's 39. You in my house, you going right to church. Now, you know, I didn't say you had to serve the Lord.
Come on.
That's right.
That's your choice.
All right.
But in my house,
yes,
you going to church. When I get up and go out the door, you going with me.
All right.
Now, I got a 52-year-old brother who lives with my mother. And I pray for him every day and all day sometimes. But when my mama go to church, he going to church.
All right.
Now mind you, he get to church and walk outside.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. That's on him.
Yeah.
But you get into the house. And he the best dressed person at church. You want everybody to know. I ain't lying. Every night at time I get to preaching, he'll come sit. And he want me to take him back home. Glory to God. But if he choose not to serve the Lord, that's on him.
That's right.
When Isaiah get 18 and out, if he decides he don't want to follow Jesus, I'm going to be the example of Jesus. I'm going to be the same. Yesterday, today, forevermore. I'm not going to change who I am. If you don't like it, that ain't on me.
That's right.
Amen.
The church, if they don't want to listen to the word of God and you, that ain't on you.
That's right. That's right.
You plant a seed.
Yes, sir.
Bible right said plant a seed.
Yes.
Somebody else come along and water.
Yeah.
Come on.
When God get good and ready, he'll give increase.
Yes, sir.
We so ready to try. trying to make folk grow, and you struggle. Did y'all know half the folk we try to make do stuff, they doing better than us?
All right.
We spend so many, we get high blood pressures, going crazy, mind head falling out, and they sit right looking at you, if you just leave me alone, you'd be all right. I've been saying a little while now.
Come on, Bridget.
No earthly security, no earthly ties, no earthly distractions. Get rid of that stuff. No control. If you're going to follow Jesus, you have no control over your own life.
That's right.
So tonight, my brothers and sisters, if we're going to count the cost of following Jesus, I want to step to the word follow.
All right.
I want to understand what it means to follow, because we follow Walmart. Mm-hmm. Every city me and my wife go in, we find Walmart.
Mm-hmm.
Did I say every city?
Mm-hmm.
I know a Walmart in Columbus. I know a in Cleveland, in Las Vegas. You know, where do we go, baby? First place we look for when we get to the city and get a rental car, we look for Walmart. Because we get a car, a rental car, and we go to a store, because we always get a hotel with kitchens.
Uh-huh.
And so we can go to a store. I don't look for the IGAs and the Safe Bars. I look for Walmart. Get everything I need in Walmart.
Amen.
Watch this. Did you know that be Walmart? And that everything a person ought to need ought to be able to come to you and get it.
All right.
Because if you've hidden the word in your heart, you ought to have a word to meet the need of people we know.
That's right.
Say, I'm Walmart.
All right.
And by the way, since it's going to be on YouTube, tell Sam Walton and his family they ain't getting no piece of this one. So if we're going to follow Jesus, we need to understand what following is really all about. Mm-hmm. Am I right?
Yep.
And so what is a follower? I ain't even gave you a scripture here.
Break it down.
Gotcha. But what is a follower? Talk to me. What? Somebody tell me. What is a follower? I know you thought I was going to preach. I told you, Lord, change me. I might get it in, but what's a follower? Talk to
someone
me.
Someone is not a fan.
Someone is not a fan. That's good. So what does it really mean? Come on, Ruth.
Ooh.
Mm. Mm.
Everybody does not has not led to Christ for the same reason. Some folk was addicted to drugs and he delivered them.
Mm-hmm.
Some folk was catching hell all day and he spoke peace to their life.
Yeah.
Are you with me?
Mm-hmm.
Some folk was on their sick bed and he healed them. And so for those reasons, they decided, somebody said, I decided to follow. Oh, that'll preach. So for this afternoon, I want to talk about, I want to piggyback off Ruthie's word, and I want to add one for me, because it's not just being committed. Because see, Jesus was, he was different.
Mm-hmm.
He's a different kind of man. God, man.
Yeah.
Am I right about it?
Yeah.
He ain't like Buddha.
That's right. Come on.
He's not like Muhammad.
Come on, preacher.
Am I right about
That's
it?
Right.
He wasn't like Confucius.
That.
Jesus is Jesus.
Yeah. All right.
And I don't care where you were born, Mexico, Sexico, or Texaco. There's only one Jesus.
That's right.
Jesus.
Yes, sir.
And he's radical. He's different.
Yes, he is.
And so if you're going to follow Jesus, you must be different.
Yeah.
Up the street in Cambridge, Kmart was here and Walmart was there. But they ain't the same.
No, they're not.
They're both shopping centers, but they're not the same.
All right.
And there are a lot of folk that claim to be Christians, the 21st century Christians, and they ain't the same.
That's right.
But if you're going to follow Jesus,
yes,
we ought to be the same.
Yes, sir. Yeah.
Can we witness?
Yeah.
So turn with me to Matthew 16.
Mm-hmm.
Turn with me to Matthew chapter 16. And let's talk about a radical commitment. That's what really being a follower means. A radical. It's going to cost you a radical commitment. Mm-hmm. So folk commit to a lot of stuff.
Yes.
I know right now, people will commit to things, but
to make
a radical commitment, there's something different about that commitment. Folk want to look at you because they, you ever heard the song, what is this?
Mm-hmm.
That makes me act so strange.
Yeah.
What is this? But whatever it is.
Yes.
Oh, my goodness.
Y'all with me?
Go ahead. Matthew 16, y'all got it?
Yes.
Let's look at verse 21. I get it back in Martin, so what you want. You keep trying to jump out of me. Mm-hmm. Matthew 16, verse 21. From that time, Jesus began to show to his disciples that he must go to Jerusalem and suffer many things from the elders and the chief priests and scribes, and be killed and be raised the third day. Then Peter, oh, y'all know him, don't you?
Yeah.
Took him aside and began to rebuke him, Jesus, saying, far be it from you, Lord, this shall not happen to you.
Mm-hmm.
But he turned and said to Peter, get thee behind me, Satan. You are an offense to me, for you are not mindful of the things that are of God, but the things of me. Then Jesus said to his disciples, if anyone desires to come after me,
all right,
let him deny himself, take up his cross, and that's what it says. For whosoever desires to save his life will lose it, but whoever loses his life for my sake will find it.
Mm.
For what profit is it a man to gain the whole world and lose? Yeah, it's in there. But what will a man give in exchange for a soul? For the Son of Man will come in his glory of his Father with his angels, and then he will reward each according to his works.
Amen.
We talked about that plow
earlier. Yes, sir.
See, you get rewarded for pushing the plow straight.
Mm-hmm.
And so I want to be able to talk, keep your Bibles open, because I need you to flip over to Proverbs 16 for a minute. And I want to talk, define commitment.
Mm-hmm.
Biblically define commitment.
All right.
In order for us to understand following, realizing to follow Jesus, it's going to cost you a commitment.
Mm-hmm.
Huh?
Yes, sir.
In Proverbs 16, Somebody read that for me, verse 3.
Submit your works to the Lord and your thoughts will be established.
All right.
Another translation says, commit to the Lord whatever you do, and your plans will succeed. Mm-hmm. Now, what does that mean, anybody?
I say, commit to the Lord first for whatever He has planned for you that'll happen.
Amen.
Commit to Him first.
Mm-hmm. Is it possible, he said, if you don't commit to the Lord, everything you do will be doomed? I said earlier, God has a way of saying things that we look at it backwards sometimes. Amen. It really makes more sense because we commit to a lot of things, but if we don't commit to God, it's possible that everything you do just won't work.
That's right.
So that doesn't mean if you commit to Him, everything will succeed, because some things don't work and it still work.
Mm-hmm.
As Joseph.
Mm-hmm.
Joseph said, what you meant for evil.
God.
And he went through some stuff, didn't he?
Yes, he did.
It wasn't nice in jail. A woman laughed and lied on him, and his friends in jail disowned him and didn't help him out. And when he finally got out, he kind of met his brothers, and he had all that stuff Joseph went through. The Bible says you meant it for bad.
Yes, sir.
Some of the stuff you go through, it might look like it's for bad.
All right.
But God got a way of bringing the good out of the bad.
Yes.
They don't know what to say about the Savior.
Yep.
All that stuff. So commitment is a dying reality in the world today. Oh, y'all better watch with this now. There are signs of dying commitment all around us.
Mm-hmm.
It's nice to see couples in the room. Because today it's hard to get good couples to say that they can celebrate 40, 30 years of marriage.
All right.
I know I'm right. I don't buy stuff on no toe, but it's a fact.
Yes, it is.
The kids at the community center, Ella and I celebrated 40 years in August. Somebody asked her today, was she six when I married her? I just know how to pick them, bro. But the kids marvel at the fact they say, y'all really married? In the 21st century.
That's right.
People marvel at the fact that y'all got 30 years together, not because she looked like she's 16, but just the fact that people are doing that today. Commitment. Folk are not committed to stuff. They go to work after they get their first paycheck. People want to disappear, take off on Monday. They ain't committed to the job, and yet you go to holler and cry, I need the job, and they give you the job, and as soon as you get a nickel, dime, or quarter, not committed to relationships. Even if you're not married and you're off, you are in a relationship. Especially these youngsters today, they gotta have trophies.
Yes.
Oh, y'all know I'm right. Come on now. Same thing happened in Cincinnati, happened in Youngstown. Young blood, you gotta have 4 or 5 girls.
That's right.
16 babies.
Uh-huh.
You know, they about no 4 or 5 no more. I be working with young men, they got 10, 12 babies. I mean, they don't even want to go to work because they know the child support is going to take all day. It's true.
Yeah.
They can't commit to nobody. That ain't no different for the women. I got some of the women out there, they got 4 or 5 men.
That's right.
And what I thought, the way I'm going to get pampers, I got to hit this one up and hit that one up and hit that one up. No commitments.
That's right.
So if you don't commit to something, you're going to fall for everything.
Yeah.
And that's what's happening today. I'm going to get there. I just need you to work with me as I'm going through this. How many of y'all, y'all out of life, y'all got nice, are they still in the playoffs? They still there? Cincinnati Reds?
Yeah.
They doing all right?
Yes.
I'm mad at them, but they. I ain't mad at them. It ain't y'all fault Cleveland keep messing up. Y'all did. mess with us the other week, but that's all right.
Okay.
We'll preach for you anyhow. No matter how hard, we will lose a draw. But watch this, watch this. Now, in baseball, you ever heard anybody make the comment they were committed to the swing?
Yeah.
Y'all, anybody know what that means? That once they got the bat, even though they didn't hit the ball, they went so far.
Yeah.
And the umpire had to say, strike!
Right, right.
Because he was committed to the swing. He tried to pull back, but right. He was into it. Say, about somebody say, into it.
Into it.
So deep that he was committed, so he couldn't come back out of it.
Right.
Now, there'll be some folk that's committed.
Mm-hmm.
So you can't get out of it.
Yes, sir.
She said, when you committed, you can't get out of it. When you committed, you can't get out of it.
Yes, sir.
And there are too many folk that can get out of stuff because they're not committed to stuff.
Yeah.
Yes.
When it comes to the church, folk ought to come to church, get committed to Christ, and say, I'm here to serve no matter what. It don't matter if the preacher talked about me on Sunday morning. I'm here because of who Jesus is.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
I used to wonder how come folk would never leave their church.
Mm-hmm.
I used to wonder, you know, folk been in church. I was here preaching when you got here.
Yes.
They can't say that about you. You started doing it. Huh? Y'all ever heard somebody say, I ain't going nowhere. I was here when he got here. Because they committed, watch this now, because they committed to the church. Y'all know where I'm going, don't you?
Yeah,
and there are a lot of folk committed to the church house.
Yeah.
But if Jesus ain't in the house.
Yeah. All right, now.
Yeah. I heard Henry Blackaby say, find out where Jesus is at.
Yep.
And go get in.
Yeah.
And too many folk so busy being committed to a place.
Come on.
And not the person of Jesus Christ.
Oh.
And if Jesus then left the building.
Come on.
We got old folk following Elvis who left the building. Last question, let me ask this, and then I'm going to really get into this thing here. What does it mean to be radical? What does it mean to be radical? Talk to me. That's good.
Yeah.
Extremely different.
Yes.
Wow.
That's good.
Could it be negative?
It could be negative. Yes, it could be.
Oh, yeah, it could be.
Now, I wasn't thinking that one, but that's showing up for real, because I know some extremely radical people.
Yeah. Yeah.
Sister Peter? Mm-hmm.
I just had an example. My brother moved from Chicago back here.
That's good.
I told him to, and he belongs to an all-white church.
In Amish country.
Yeah. And so what he did was, since he was the only black person at the church, he went and got some black construction paper and cut out silhouettes of himself and posted them in the church in different places.
That rapper, we go visit it, and we see all these little silhouettes around, and so we, you know, you got to ask, what's that all about? He said, I ain't alone. Say that one more time.
Narrow-minded?
Oh. Oh.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Y'all talking about church folk, boy. Guess what? Can I go back to football and baseball?
Yeah.
You see a whole lot of radicalness when you're watching TV. I get tickled to death. You see 40, 50-year-old folk that's executives on their jobs at a football game painted brown and orange. Y'all saw a black. They ain't teenagers. They ain't no 19-year-old cats at the football stadium standing there butt naked in front of the TV screen. They got gray hair. And fat. Amen.
Amen.
That's radical. authority, right? Even though it's a Cincinnati, they've got a seat.
Yeah, you know.
And the Browns too. I don't know, in my neck of the wood, I'm on the border. It's Pittsburgh Steelers country. I'm in Ohio. I'm trying to still, I got a friend living in Cleveland. He moved here and I said, why anybody in Youngstown like the Pittsburgh Steelers? You in Ohio. I said, they ain't crazy. They're crazy, but when I tell you they're crazy in Youngstown about Pittsburgh, they're crazy. Mm. Their cars painted black and gold.
Mm.
Hey. I got four. Come on, sir.
He committed to their cause.
He was at it. Don't know about Jesus Christ.
Wouldn't it be all right? I wouldn't have to be here today. At least I can change the message. Let's just have some fun. Because that's what they do in the football, baseball game. They have fun. Because they're ready. Crazy about that team, it will hurt you.
Yes, they will.
They will hurt you about that. Don't you dare talk about that team.
That's right.
And if they start to lose, if they ain't winning, they're going to hurt you even more. You on the opposite team and you going down the walkway and y'all done whooped their butt, then somebody hit you in the back of the head with a cane.
Yeah.
For radical! Yeah. That's what I'm trying to get you to understand. In order to serve the Lord, the cost of following Jesus, he's looking for radical commitment from folk.
Right.
Folk that are crazy for him.
Yes.
Folk that are going out of their way. Folk go out their way to get to a ball game.
Yeah.
We were coming from Columbus last week. We had to be in Columbus. And I'm driving up the road from Columbus. And Ohio State Buckeyes. And I'm a fan of them too. But let me tell you, there were lines of cars, red and scarlet and red, everywhere. Yeah. We pulled over at a rest stop, scarlet and red everywhere. If I could only get a few
food.
To just love you like that. Matthew 16. He says in verse 21, from that time on, Jesus began to explain to his disciples that he must go to Jerusalem and suffer many things, and at the hands of the elders, chief priests, teachers of the law, that he must be killed and on the third day rise. Matthew 16, verse 22, Peter took him aside. I said, y'all, Peter, he radical. Peter took Jesus aside, the Bible says, and rebuked him. Now you got nerve. That's nerve. You know. I mean, one thing for folk in church pull me aside and say, look, Pastor. I got a few too. Look, Pastor, that ain't the way we do it. I got one, I just told a couple of them at dinner, I got one so bold, he became the Facebook pastor. And I won't even let him preach. He didn't claim himself to be the Facebook pastor.
Mm.
Folk crazy. Folk crazy. They crazy. In the wrong way, instead of serving the Lord crazily, you just want, and I guess that's his way of serving the Lord, but he's going to get the best woman in life. Because being a pastor, amen, we didn't run for the job.
Right.
We was chosen.
Yes, sir.
When you're chosen and you call, you go.
Yes, sir.
When you start talking about I am, you better watch yourself. The thing you allowed to say I am nothing.
Yeah.
Peter took him aside and rebuked him. Remember, Lord, he said, this shall never happen to you. Jesus turned and said to Peter, get behind me, Satan.
Yes.
You're a stumbling block to me.
Mm.
You're not having in mind the things of God, but the things of men. You're talking worldly.
Mm-hmm.
I'm trying to do something for my father. You all up in the way. Jesus, in the text, is setting an example for us to follow our following our commitment.
Yeah.
Jesus was committed to go where he was not wanted. Am I right about it?
Yeah.
He was committed to suffer for people who rejected him.
Yep.
He was committed to die for a lost world.
That's right.
He was committed to the ultimate victory. If you're going to follow Christ, you've got to be committed to the cause.
Yes, sir.
You got to understand that you need to, or you need to understand the cause and follow it.
Mm-hmm.
See, the problem here, with Peter, the Greek word in here means, when it says that Peter took him aside, implied that Peter literally grabbed Jesus.
Mm.
Hello? Mm. Can you imagine that? Now, he's been following a few weeks here now, and he's been done a couple miracles. Hello, somebody.
Yeah.
It ain't like he just showed up and Jesus was there. He'd been with him.
Yeah.
And here he is. Jesus trying to educate him. As a matter of fact, if you know the record says he's trying to explain to them because he's about to leave them.
Right.
So he's been with them for 3 years plus.
Yes.
You have seen all the work that I've done, and yet the Bible says he grabbed him.
Yes.
My Lord.
Think about that.
Mm.
And said, look, you ain't about to do that. And Jesus said, boy, you better get out of my face. I every now and then I read my Bible, I wish I was there. I'd be, you know, what's wrong with that move?
Who grabbed Jesus? God is good.
Yeah.
Sometimes you gotta realize
hell don't do. But so that I can make, open the door for people who have a need.
Yes, sir.
And that's a radical move, because most folk don't want to have meet the needs of people. They just want to have church.
That's right. Yeah.
Yes, yes, sir.
That's right.
Yes.
That's right.
Yes. Mm-hmm. I stepped off on that, but I'm back.
That's all right.
Jesus demonstrated a radical commitment by willing, being willing to die. Then he calls for a radical commitment. What's that Jesus said in verse 24? He said, if anyone would come after me, he must, somebody say must, deny himself and take up his cross. Oh yeah, and follow me. Three things that you got, that'll preach all by itself. We can just take that one verse and go for the next 6 months with that.
Yes, sir.
And some folk got to learn to deny. That the man, the last guy this morning, the rich young ruler, ain't that what he told him?
Yep.
You got to deny you who you is. I know you got all this rich, you rich, you got money, you look good, you're fine, got a nice horse, driving a horsey Cadillac and all that other stuff. But if you don't follow me, you say you want to inherit the kingdom, let it go.
Yeah.
Too many folk don't, it's a call to be a radical.
Yeah.
Letting go of who you think you are is radical. Because everybody want to be somebody.
Yeah.
And everybody want to be loved by somebody.
Yeah.
But I stopped by to tell you, Jesus loved you. This I know.
Yeah.
Yeah. Everybody looking for love in the wrong place.
Yeah.
In the words of Eddie Murphy, looking for love in the wrong place.
Yeah.
We all. Let it run around here trying to get a hookup. Get a hookup with Jesus.
Yes,
my Bible says, you know, you hook up with Jesus.
Yes, sir.
His supply is
okay. Yeah.
I ain't got nothing to walk for with Jesus. I can't pay my bills. Hey, Jesus. Huh? Now, he might tell me to go to work.
Say it, sir.
There you go. Watch this. There's no such thing as low-cost grace. No such thing as low-cost grace. No such thing as low-cost Christianity. Jesus is calling you to an all-or-nothing deal. He wants all of your life. Counting the cost, following Jesus will cost you your life. Watch this. I got to read something that I wrote. I like this. I admit I took it from somebody. He said to me earlier, I'm going to use some of that. All this ain't me.
All right.
It's a counterintuitive question. Following Jesus costs you a life that is dying in exchange for a life that never ends.
Mm.
Oh, that's good.
That's good.
That's good. Following Jesus dying. will cost you a life that's dying. You're dying every day.
Yeah.
For a life that will never end.
Never
that's good. Following Jesus costs you a life of bondage in exchange for a life of freedom.
All right.
Following Jesus will cost you a life that is cursed in exchange for a life that's blessed.
All right.
That don't sound too bad to me.
No, sir.
I think I'd like to have a life that's blessed.
Yes,
when
sir.
I look at all of the cursing I get every day, oh Lord. But there are two problems that we have as people. There's selfishness and stubbornness. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
All right.
So Jesus calls us to tear down the altar of selfishness that we might build and embrace a radicalness. The stubbornness can build and get rid of the selfishness that we got. He wants selflessness.
Yeah.
Y'all get y'all ready to go to bed?
No.
I got another hour and a half. I know that's right. Sound like an asshole. I appreciate that. Reverend, I love you, but. I see the mic in, but on a tape with my voice. Commitment is what Jesus is looking for in all our lives. He wants us to have a desire to follow him in a radical way.
Yeah.
The cost of following Jesus caused radical change. Radical. When you think about where you come from, let me pause for a moment. I know somebody may holler around and shout. But when you really think about what God has brought you from,
amen.
First of all, it took something radical to change.
Yes. Yeah. Hallelujah.
because most of us did more than change.
Yeah.
Amen.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I know. Mm-hmm. The last part, then I'm going to let you know. Verse 25 to 28, the importance of radical commitment. For whosoever wants to save his life will lose it. But whosoever loses his life for me will find it. Mm-hmm. What good would it profit a man to gain the whole world and lose his soul? Or what can a man give in exchange for his soul? For the Son of Man is going to come in his Father's glory with his angels.
Yeah.
And then he will reward each person according to what he has done. I tell you the truth, he says, some of who are standing here will not taste death before they see the Son of Man coming in his kingdom. Radical commitment means that we will put our complete trust in Christ. The whole power of salvation rests on the efforts of Jesus and Jesus alone.
Amen.
If you cannot trust Jesus with all your heart, somebody
yes,
say that.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Y'all know the scripture.
Yes, sir.
Trust in the Lord.
Amen.
With some of your heart.
Uh-oh. No.
What does all mean? But when you wake up in the morning, don't do something.
Come on.
Don't get up in the morning and take it for granted that you just got up.
Yes, sir.
Because I don't know about you, but it takes radical commitment to fall on your knees and say thank you.
Thank you. Yes, sir.
Because it's so easy to get up, you know, just, man, I don't care, I'm watching the TV, I got to be there. It takes a radical commitment to get at a dinner table with your friends who ain't following Jesus.
All right.
And say a prayer.
Yes, sir.
For the young folk in the room, it takes a radical commitment to go to the movies with a boy that's trying to hit on you.
Uh-oh.
And sit two rows over.
Uh-oh.
Uh-huh.
Because
mm-hmm. you know what he wants you to do.
All right.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Ain't got nobody.
Yeah.
Because if you can go to the movie and he find you sit over there, and then he like, what's wrong? Oh, I'm fine. He don't think you crazy. Or when I just spent my money. I used to be one of them. I just spent my money. You gonna sit over there? What I do? You haven't done nothing, and you ain't about to. You ain't gonna sit next to me? I'm sitting next to you. Ain't nobody gonna get in here. I got this. You know what we do it at church?
Mm-hmm.
We sit apart. But when it comes to dating, we want to give up everything. I talk about this in my church. I like a lot of young people. I want them to know.
Yes,
lock it up.
Yeah. Amen.
And I don't just say tell a girl to lock it up. I tell a boy to pack it up. You gonna follow Jesus. You gotta lock it up and back it up.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
You can't just be doing like every other Tom, Dick, and Harry. Ain't nobody here named Tom, Dick, or Harry. Okay. We talking about following Jesus. The cost of following Jesus is being totally different. Totally different.
Amen.
And we got to become the Walmarts of the Christian world. So that when everybody see everybody that say they're Christian, we all looking and walking the same. When you come to us, you might not have the same word because you may not read the Bible. You might read John today. You might read Mark. You might read Elijah. I don't know whatever you're going to read, but at least you got a word for somebody instead of giving folk your opinion. Well, you know, baby. It's going to be all right. No, it ain't going to be all right. I heard a preacher say the other day, you know, even for us, we do funerals. One of the first things we want to do up in the funeral when someone had lost their mama, lost their child, let not your heart be.
Sure.
It's for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever puts your name there, believing in him shall not perish but have everlasting life. Do you know that'll save a whole nation?
Yeah.
If everything you did, if that's all, everywhere you go, and here she comes with the same scripture, I'm going to say it to you again. Then you can change your life. Quit trying to memorize the whole Bible and get messed up. Know what you know, and when you know what you know, you can do what you do with what you know. And if all you know is trust in the Lord, go to Walmart, stand in front, tell a few folks, trust in the Lord with all your heart. Don't lean to your understanding when you got it close. In all your ways, you know him. He'll direct your path. Sooner or later, most folk gonna avoid you. But sooner or later, somebody gonna come step next to you. And they're gonna say, what did you say? And you're going to speak to them, and then you can give your testimony.
Yes.
Because that's what's going to save folk. When they realize he delivered you from whatever you was going through, he can deliver them too.
Yes.
Quit hiding who you are and where you've been.
That's right, amen.
Quit being ashamed of being a drunk.
Right.
Quit being ashamed of being an alcoholic.
Right.
Quit being ashamed of being a drug addict.
Yes.
Quit being ashamed of being a prostitute.
Yes.
Quit being ashamed of all those things you used to be. Because the key word is used to be.
Yeah.
I know I got somebody now. I'm glad I know what I used to be. I realize I ain't what I'm going to be. But I'm thankful for what I am. I'm glad the Lord had brought me from a mile long
way.
When I look back over my life and simply go.
Testimony.
I've done some crazy things. I've been to some crazy places. But God is able.
That's
me. He's able to say to the uttermost.
Because
that's where he found me. And if he can place my feet on solid ground, there's a whole lot of folk I know he can move in their life and change the heart. If he can do it for me, he can do it for you. So, the cost of following him requires a radical commitment.
Yes, it does.
And when we get radical about Jesus, like them Cincinnati Reds and Bengals and Browns and Steelers and all the other folks, they go to their church.
Yes.
Early Sunday.
Yes.
Early Sunday. On time. Most of them folk, they stay on the back when the game starts. Hello?
Yep.
Church folk.
Mm-hmm.
Before the game starts, say that would be.
Yeah.
Just Sunday morning, bro, your church gonna be back before the game starts. And they got their colors and they're ready to go.
Mm-hmm.
And when the first kick or the first pitch go, they screaming and hollering.
Yeah.
And they holler till the end of the game. 4 hours later. 2 hours later. Don't get laryngitis.
Mm-hmm.
When you get to trying to get church folk to holler for Jesus.
Amen.
So say, come on, somebody say
that. I say, man, I'm tired of asking.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Talk about it, Pastor. Yes.
Right now.
If you don't cry out,
yes, sir.
The rocks will cry.
Right.
And ain't no rock.
Right.
Don't cry.
Nah.
I love you.
We love you.
And I just want you to follow God with all you got.
All right.
It's gonna cost you something.
Yes, it is.
But it's worth it.
Yes, it is.
When you follow Jesus for all, he gives his all.
Yes.
The best part is, we say he gave his all. He still gave it.
Yes.
That's what I love about Jesus. Even though he gave his life and he died on the cross, he sent the Holy Ghost.
Yes, sir.
Maybe the lie give you the real definition of the difference in the Holy Spirit and the Holy Ghost. But he sent the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
And so as long as you got the Holy Ghost, he's still giving.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. He ain't departing yet. I'm glad I know the Holy Ghost ain't left here, because when he leave here, I'm gone. Look for me and I'll be gone. I love you. God bless you.
Yeah.